secrets to different bills. At Uncle Demon, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Went from the finish to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drop my name.
Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is your man, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you. Right now, before we get into this video, please go ahead and drop a like if you haven't already done so. If you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe. Obviously, we're making a massive push for 14,000 subs at the end of this week. Hopefully, we can be able to get that 14. I'm having a goal to roughly like, maybe like to have like 18,000 by the end of January. So, you know, we just got a couple goals I'm trying to hit, and it just starts with one sub and one like at a time, man. So if you can do that for me, that'd be greatly appreciated. All right, now, back to the video. Now, we have Tyrone Muggsy Bogues. Now, you know, everybody's been asking about, you know, me making a 5'7 player. And I said, well, you know what? You know, as Uncle Demi, you know, I'm like, listen, if I'm going to go small, I'm going to go as small as possible. Muggsy Bogues is the smallest basketball player to ever play in the NBA. Me being from North Carolina, obviously the Charlotte Hornets was a team that I was followed greatly. I was a huge Magic fan, because of Shaquille O'Neal. But obviously being North Carolina and seeing Charlotte, that was a team that obviously I followed heavily. So of course I know a lot about Muggsy Bogues. Right now, if you don't know much about Muggsy Bogues, again, he's the shortest player to ever play in the NBA. But when I tell you, man, he was like the quickest, fastest, shiftiest thing you could ever see on the floor. It used to be so crazy to watch him play in the NBA. If you cannot visualize 5'3", just imagine a 5'3". I mean, if you have like a girlfriend or you might know 5'3" or whatever, it's almost like, for me, it's like literally having like my daughter, right? Literally on the basketball court with 7-foot individuals. I mean, like, you think about it, it's ridiculous to think. If you look at these pictures, Muggsy Bogues literally would come up to some of these guys, like literally like right there at their belly buttons, man. Like, he was so short, but his defense used to be ridiculous. He was like a little annoying gnat because he was so close to the ground and basketball players had to literally like bend their knees and squat really low to protect the ball when he was guarding them. So there was a lot of advantages that Muggsy had for being short, but obviously there was tons and tons of disadvantages. Muggsy Bogues was not a great shooter. He was just a really good facilitator, spark plug. He just pushed, he hustled hard. You know how you get the same type of sayings, you know, he had the biggest heart out there. Like, it literally took a lot of effort and a lot of work for Muggsy Bogues to be successful in the league. And when I say successful, I say that, you know, with a grain of salt. I mean, he averaged 7 points a game. He averaged 7 assists a game. I think the 7 assists a game is really what's pretty prominent for him, because averaging almost 8 assists a game is pretty dope. So, I mean, it really lets you know what type of playmaker he was, facilitator. Back then, there was a stacked, loaded team. So you can imagine the players that they had on their team at the time. They had Dale Curry. They had Larry Johnson. They had, I'm not sure if Vlade Divac was there at that time, but they were just good. And I know we set the record for most consecutive sellouts. I remember hearing about that when back then when we were playing. We had like the most consecutive sellouts before, of course, the Hornets ended up moving to the New Orleans. So let's just take a look at Muggsy Bogues here. He's 86 overall. He's an offensive threat. He is 5'3", 144 pounds. You can see automatically, like, you know, the standing dunk is low, driving dunk's low, the close shots are 90, the driving layups are 77. This is what threw me off, right? So 93-84 is definitely not Muggsy Bogues, and I'm sorry, it's just not. I literally lived through this time of watching the play. He was not a good shooter like that at all. Actually, you know what I could do? I can even see it. Do they have their stats here? Watch this. This is dirty. All right, yeah, check this out. So, look at this. He's 40%, 25% here. He shot 41% here. He didn't even shoot anything here. He shot 20% from three here, 16% from three, 23%, 74% from three. shoot all this the whole time. He's shooting below 40%. Look at 19% from three, 77% from three, 18% from three. He's a career 27% three-point shooter, but yet somehow they got him at an 84 and a 93 mid-range shot. I mean, listen, I'm not trying to knock him. I just know, like, it's hard for me to look past that because, I, like I said, I was there. I saw him play. So this is extremely exaggerated of him. He was not a good shooter at all. His three-point shot should be somewhere like in, you know, the low 60s. His mid-range shot should be somewhere in the 70s. He was a very quick slasher. He went to the basket and he looked to pass. Most of his points literally was from the fast break. In the half court set, he was not taking, he was not doing anything offensively unless he was spotting up, and he rarely shot the ball. He always passed up on shooting because he knew that was a limitation of his. So the big thing for him, of course, now the 95 pass, there we go. So this right here, I can 100% agree with. He was extremely quick. He was literally the quickest on the floor. By virtue, he wouldn't be the fastest because obviously players that are just taller could just, it's just by science or physics, you know, someone that is 6'6", that has a longer stride is going to go down the court faster than Muggsy. So Muggsy wasn't necessarily the fastest, but he was definitely the quickest. Speed of ball, 95, I think that's a little too high, but, you know, let me see, perimeter defense, ouch. I think perimeter defense should have been a little bit better than that. Not because, 79 still, okay, I can take that, okay. So, because he averaged, he definitely had to average over still a game, because he literally got a lot of steals, he's very active. Yo, 27% block, but if everybody knows, he actually did block Patrick Ewing. I think that might be one of the lowest points for Patrick Ewing to get blocked. But by a 5'3" guard. But hey, man, it happens to the best of us. He's still a Hall of Famer. Lateral, whoa, yeah. See, that right there is a little disappointing because lateral quickness should definitely be, I mean, come on, man. So he has an 84-3, but he has a 73 lateral quickness. 2K. I don't know about that one, man. Cause yeah, I don't know about that one at all. Not unless there's a different type of like metric that they're trying to weigh on a lateral quickness, but. There was no one quicker than Muggsy Bogues. There was no one quicker than Muggsy Bogues. Look at his highlights. He could, I mean, like, literally, he was like a jackrabbit out there. He was so quick and agile, man. He could move left and right with the best of them, so I'm not sure about that. Let's just go over here to the badges. Giant Slayer Hall of Fame. Yeah, yeah. You 5'3" going in there with them dogs, man. You better be, man. What is this? What is that? He has put back balls on silver. Yeah. Oh, what? Yeah, that don't. Teardrop. Okay. Yo, did y'all see this? Or am I tripping? Put back balls on silver? Yeah, that's not happening. Difficult shots? Yeah, almost every shot he shot was difficult. It was hard to get shots up. Playmaking? Yeah, all this right here makes sense. Space creator, stop and go. Anchor break. I was looking for anchor break. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. So playmaking, that makes sense. All right. Defense, pick dodger. Okay, yeah, pickpocket. Yep, that makes sense. I have no gripes about that. Okay, so basically, let's go ahead and head over to the My Player Builder and see if I can emulate. Obviously, we can't make someone that's 5'3", but let's see if we can emulate the best Muggsy Bogues we can. And this will be the first time I made a 5'7" guard on my channel. So I'm really excited to show this to y'all. So let's head over there right now. Okay, so obviously Muggsy Bogues was a point guard, right? He was right-handed. He was number one. Okay, now I thought about doing the pure playmaking pie chart for obvious reasons, but I ended up going with the playmaking and the shooting because for some reason 2K believes that he's a shooter. So I'm like I said, my job is just to emulate what we see on the all-time rosters and try to make it here in the My Player Builder. So we're gonna go ahead and make him a play shot, right? Plus he says offensive threat, so we're gonna go ahead and try to make offensive threat. So let's get it. I went with the speed invert. I know if y'all didn't see that, but his vert's at 95, so and his speed was obviously not as high as I thought it would be, but I'm sorry, his speed was a 95 also. So his speed 95, his vert was 95, his lateral quickness is what it, I didn't think it would be, so we went here. Okay, and then for what we did here, I ended up doing maxing out close shot and driving layup and then post hook, right? So because obviously he had 25s here, I just went here just so I can get three badges. I just want to at least get three. And then I went 84 here, and then I just went 80 here because obviously, you know, I'm trying to get the same exact numbers that he has and in his builder. Now, I did go 72 here just for the bass potential. So obviously, he doesn't have a post fade. I'd rather just his mid-range and three-point shot be similar. The post fade is something that 2K has done, which I do not know why post hook, post fade, and post moves are in three different categories. It literally should, I kind of understand what they're doing. It's extremely hard to try to figure out where to put certain attributes at, attribute categories within, you know, these different type of finishing, shooting, playmaking, defense. But to me, it makes absolutely no sense that like, for instance, like what I'm doing here as playmakers, a playmaker would have to have post moves. Think about this, post moves, when 99% of these guys would not have that. So I have to max all this out, but just so I can get 23 playmaking badges. But let's be honest, Muggsy Bogues doesn't have no post move, and a lot of guards don't have post moves, right? There's a very, very select few of guards that actually have post moves, but regardless, this is what we're working with, so we're going to do that, all right? I'm maxing out interior defense, the perimeter defense. Lateral quickness is a 72. I got my steals at a 75, and then I left the remaining on the block. Oh, there we go. So that gets three, right? So that's going to be perfect. He had six defensive badges, but this is what I'm going with, because obviously going here with the offensive rebounds and that type of deal on defense, that wasn't much to me needed. I put the blocks at 41 because he did actually have, I think he had like 50-something blocks in his career. So, yeah, so that's pretty dope. All right, so as you can see, let's go ahead and actually, before we do that, let's just look at the badges. We have 3 finishing, 19 shooting, 23 playmaking, and 3 defensive. That's not bad at all. Now, obviously, you can get a ton more badges with the offensive threat, but we're trying to make Muggsy Bogues here, so we're going to go with that, all right? Now, with the body type, you're definitely going built because, like I've been saying, I think I'm the original OG on making big bulky guards. I remember in the beginning, people used to always be like, oh, why you have a built guard? Well, because if you lower the weight all the way down, they actually look pretty decent and don't look really skinny. And now I start to see a lot of people during their little videos, and they're like, oh yeah, I'm gonna make them built because I lowered the weight. I feel like I am definitely a trendsetter, right? So we're gonna go 5'7" because we can't go 5'3". Now just keep in mind, this 5'7", you actually gotta go 4 inches shorter than this. All right, but the cool thing is that his speed and acceleration are now 95s. His vert is an 86. Remember, that gets a +8. So that will actually get him to a 94 vert. So that's going to be pretty good. 99 speed, 99 acceleration, right? He was 144 pounds. We can only go to 145. So as you can see, even though 145, he was 5'3", 144. So he was a really stocky, very strong, pound for pound, the strongest guy in the league. Because he literally was he was gifted everywhere. I mean, he was gifted athletically, but he just didn't have the height. But if Muggsy Bogues was 6'3 instead of 5'3, he would definitely have been an all-time great. And just for him to even be considered just a guard that can play, I think he played 14 years in the league at 5'3. So that really tells you a lot about him. You look at all the other great ones like Spud Webb, Nate Robinson. I think those are the two other short guards you think about, and they weren't even as short as him. But if you were to compare careers, I would say that Muggsy Bogues had the longest longevity, and he was also the better player out of the three, right? Even though Spud Webb and Nate Robinson had the flash with the dunk contest, Muggsy Bogues had a career, right? Whereas, you know, as you know, Nate Robinson, he's not even in the league anymore. He bounced around for a little bit. He just really wasn't able to really establish himself. And then, of course, Spud Webb, he had a pretty good career, but it wasn't as long either. And obviously, you know, he's just more so known for a dunk contest, right? And you might say Muggsy Bogues for, you know, like the older ones. Well, the only thing he's known for is Space Jam with Michael Jordan, because he was in Space Jam, but I digress. So what we're going to do here is we're also going to lower his wingspan all the way down. So remember, his three-point shot was like 83, 84. We got it at 84. His mid-range was 95. We got that to 91. So that's pretty much right there. His pass accuracy was 95. We got it to 90. His ball handling matched perfectly up. His lateral quickness was like a 75, 73. We got it to an 83, which will get it to an 87. His steals are going to be pretty good also. So that's going to be pretty good. So I think we got pretty much what we're looking for Muggsy Bogues, right? What we're going to do here, obviously, none of these badges will work best. I think the playmaking is truly what Muggsy Bogues was. The game itself is really trying to make him more of a, like, you know, a shooter, but he's not. He's not a shooter. As you can see, he shot like 20-something percent from three. So we're going with the pure playmaker, right? So with the pure playmaking, we had the offensive threat. Obviously, you're not going to have Muggsy Bogues in the game for, you know, but this is would be something similar to Muggsy Bogues. Tim Hardaway, Chris Paul, and Kemba Walker are nowhere near the height that he was. So I'm just a little head scratcher that they didn't have smaller guard similarities in here. So when you hit 5'7", all these guys should be eliminated. And then they should be talking about like the Earl Boykins or the Earl Watson and Spud Webb, Nate Robinson. There's a lot of short players that played in the league. So I'm just, you know, it's a little disheartening to see that they don't have short players in here to make them similar to. Hopefully next year they'll have more in a database so you can get these comparisons a little bit better than what they were, because I felt like I genuinely matched up a lot of his attributes. So this should have been a Muggsy Bogues, but obviously he's not in a database. All right, but let's go ahead and taste it out real quick. And obviously we're going to get him to 99 real quick. Whenever this thing loads up, there we go. All right. And then what we're going to do here, what we're going to do is just go straight Giant Slayer. So we want to go ahead and get the Giant Slayer, heightened effectiveness of layups over taller defenders. You should get extremely crazy boost off that, because I'm looking at 2K last. Once you, like, I think it's like, once there's like a 6-inch difference, you almost get like a 40% boost, right, on your layup. So you should get a lot, even though contact finisher, you know, you might think that's great, but I think in this instance, Giant Slayer will be the best, right? So we're going to go Giant Slayer on gold. Here, what we're going to do, and again, he's not a shooter, but this is what we're going to go with. So at his height, I do not even think you might be able to get away with bronze quick draw. The shorter you are, the quicker your shot is. So let's not be crazy and think that we need to go Hall of Fame. If you went Hall of Fame, this would probably be a tap of the button. I mean, not even a tap, man. I'm talking about, you might have to have a modded controller to hit the green window. Let's just go silver, and I think that might be pushing it. Maybe silver might be equivalent to Hall of Fame. Who knows? But let's just go silver, because he is 5'7", with the shortest wingspan possible. That is a very quick shot without even having to put quick draw on. You might not even have to do it, man. You might just need to put on bronze. Then we'll just do the simple things that we always do, okay? We're gonna go range extender, we'll go hot zone hunter, we'll go green machine, and we'll go volume shooter, right? Because obviously this is what you're doing as a guard up top. These are the badges that you need as a primary ball handler. You don't need catch and shoot, you don't need corner specialist. These are the badges you need right here, because as a guard bringing the ball to court, this is what you're gonna have. Last but not least, you can go ahead and get difficult shots if you wanted to, or you can go dead eye. And for me, that's what I'm going to go with. I'm going to go with dead eye. All right. So obviously, Muggsy Bogues, only thing he had was difficult shots. Well, we're going to go ahead and make him playable in 2K. And these are the badges we're going to give him. Right. And then for here, obviously, we're going to go quick first step. We're going to go handles for days. Right. We're going to go dimer. We're going to go tight handles. We're going to go unpluckable. We're going to go ankle breaker. And then where's the other one at? Then we're going to go floor general, right? So these are the badges that we're going to go with for him. I think this is going to be pretty crazy to be 5'7 and doing the things that he's going to be doing. He didn't have any Hall of Fame badges, but I definitely want to get these two to Hall of Fame. Obviously, you need those. Unpluckable, tight handles, ankle breaker, floor general, dimer. All these are really good badges. Maybe you can drop it down here and go a little bit higher if you wanted to. Maybe do that if you wanted to, to really help out your teammates. So it's really your call. This is what I'm thinking would be good. Either tight handles and unpluckable gold with floor general and dimer gold, or go Hall of Fame here and make these silver if you wanted to. Or if you wanted to go, like, I mean, it's your call, man. It's your bill. You can do any way you want to. But this is, like I said, Muggsy Bogues. And then last but not least, we're going to go with pickpocket here on gold, because he did have pickpocket on gold and he did have pick dodger. But I'm just going to go ahead and go pickpocket on gold. I think this is extremely good build, well thought out, for a 5'7 player, right? And there you have it, my nephews and nieces, man. This is your Muggsy Bogues, my first 5'7 player that I made on my channel. I hope you enjoyed this channel. If you did, go ahead and please drop a like. If you haven't already subbed to the channel, please sub to the channel. Tons and tons of more content coming down the pipeline. But other than that, my nephews and nieces, I'll be back really soon with another banger. And you know, when I say I'll be back soon with another banger, I know what day I'm talking about, man. I'm talking about tomorrow. I'm out. Try to drag my name in dirty, try to bring me down. See me winning, you ain't like me then. No, you ain't me now.
All of them coppers tried to call me, I could see them.